Hey there everyone, it's Ashley. Welcome back to my channel. I'm thrilled to be hopping with Alternu today for their newest Build-A-Flower release, and this is the Bellflower. As you can see here, I've got the stamp set and the coordinating dies, and on the die packaging you can see the four images that you make with all of these stamps, and each flower has four layers to it, so you get a lot of detail and you can bring in a lot of colors and shading and highlights, and I love that. Lots of great detail for these flowers. You can see the layering guide on the back, and as always, I'm going to pull out the pamphlet because it's so beautiful. It's a tri-fold pamphlet, so when you open it, you get lots of inspiration and color inspiration, as well as a few cards that you could cut out and use on a card front and just make a super easy card. So that's always great as well. And of course, the guide is on the back with some color inspiration and ink inspiration. I'm going to do something a little bit different today, and I got this idea recently from Yana Smakula, who I love. I think she can do no wrong as far as card making goes. And she recently did a video for a decoupage on her layering stamps. Now, basically what that means is that you take lots of different layers, and once you've cut them all down, you sort of put them all together with foam tape and you make a multi-dimensional image. And for this technique, you need several images, since you are going to be cutting different layers from different images and sort of adding them all together to become one. So I'm going to do a lot of images here. I'm going to put on a little music. I wanted you to be able to see how all of the layers come together and all the great detail. So I don't want to skip over it too much, but I do go through it really quickly as to not bore you. So now that I'm finishing up the stamps, I'll go ahead and use the coordinating dies to cut these out. Now I've done the main flower that is completely open. I've done a few of the sort of like half bloomed flowers and then a few of the buds because I really think that it'll be nice to get all of the different images on the card. As you can see, I left the bottom blank. So that's what I'm doing now, is I'm stamping out this part of the flower. This is the very bottom of the sort of like the base of the flower that has tiny little green leaves coming off of it. And I want this to be an extra part of the dimension to my flowers. So what I'm going to do is use the die to cut that out and then use the scissors, my small detail scissors, just to cut the rest of that part out. Now I'll be able to adhere that later on with foam tape, and that will be another layer to the dimension of the flower. So as you can see here, I'm just cutting out this piece from the flower. It's a little difficult to do only because it hurts to actually cut the image up, but as you can see, it fits on perfectly with the other flower. And if you wanted to get really fun and do different color inks, you could absolutely do that and make a really fun flower. So I went ahead and put some foam tape onto the back. First, I'm doing this first layer of the petals, and I'm using just a really thin foam tape, and I'm placing that exactly where it would go if I were actually placing it on top of it. So it's the same exact image, it's just now it has a little bit more dimension. I'm going into that base of the flower now and just putting some really tiny pieces of foam tape there, and then I'm going to add that to the top of that layer. Now I've got three layers. So I have my base layer, I have the front petals as a layer, and then I've got the base of the flower layer. So there's three layers here. I'm going to sort of move it around so you can see all of the layers. And I'll give you a close-up photo at the very end of the video, but I just really love that this all comes together and makes one image with several different pieces of dimension and layer on it. You can do lots of different combinations. So here I'm just cutting out the very back of the petal, and then I'm going to use this entire front as some dimension rather than just the bottom front half of that flower. And that way I get even a little bit more dimension than before. So I'd like to show you my card now, and this is how I ended up setting up the scene. I did two stalks or two stems with these flowers coming off, and as you can see when you get close, you can really see the dimension. You can see the three layers there, and then also on just the buds of the flower and that other flower, the two layers also gives it a lot of dimension, and I really love how that came out. I hope that you've enjoyed learning a little bit about how you can decoupage your own layering dies. I want to thank Yana again for all of the wonderful inspiration. As always, links to all of the products used are in the description, as well as the link to the blog hop. Thanks so much for stopping by, and I'll see you again soon. Thank you. Bye.